Good morning, friends. I am thinking that this was just the perfect morning to kind of share with you guys why I use biodegradable film, what the real great benefits of it are. And so I'm just going to walk along and kind of just show you and tell you why this works so well for me here on my flower farm. And so what we're looking at here are actually tomatoes, because we grow vegetables for ourselves too. But before we get started, I just want to point out that first off, you'll see that there's still row cover and weight bags down here in this garden. And that's why the garden is a little messier than it normally would be. See, I can't mow my pathways yet, which I'm going to talk about that in a second. But that is because tonight it's going down to 50 or even in the high 40s. And so this evening, probably about 5 o'clock or so, I'm just gonna pull these covers back up just for added protection. We have protected these warm season annuals for so long now that I am not gonna let a late little snap, it wouldn't kill them, but it would perhaps stress them or damage them a little bit. So I decided I'm just gonna show y'all, even though my pathways are a little unruly, this is what they look like before I start my weekly mowing. And I also wanna say, in case I forget, I don't know if you've seen our live streaming camera that's here on YouTube, and you can also find it on our website. The real purpose of that is not to sit and watch us do something, because occasionally you can find us out here doing something, but it's watching how my garden progresses through the season is really the big benefit. So check out our farm cam live stream, and you can also find it over on the Gardener's Workshop, and you can find it right here on YouTube. So these are our tomatoes, and you can see that we have composted around the plant. You know, you have to make a hole to put the plant in, and then that hole will actually grow weeds in it if the plant doesn't grow up fairly quickly and shade them out. And because tomatoes are tomatoes, that tends to happen a little bit more. So in our effort to not have to do so much hole weeding, we just literally put a little pile of compost to cover the hole and to shore up the plants. So we're just walking along here. We plant usually our first planting of tomatoes. We plant a whole bed, which is about 35 or 40 plants, and then I have some peppers down here at the end. And what I wanna share with you is kind of how I use the film to really be the overall weed controller on my farm, even though, as you can see, weeds will pop up through it. That's nut sedge. Nut sedge will grow through anything. So I did the same thing with our peppers down here, although the compost is not quite as tied up around the stem. So let's get over here, excuse me, and you can see this is all, we just allow whatever is going to pop up and grow to grow, and then it gets mowed weekly. And that weekly mowing will start as soon as these bags are up and the row cover and the hoops. And that all we suspect is going to happen on Monday. So this is a mixed bed of several different warm season tender annuals, as well as even a cool flower. This is basil. So what happens, and see, you can see there's a few little weeds that pop up through the hole. Sometimes we hole weed, we call that hole weeding. Sometimes we don't. But here is the thought process that I have experienced, what I think, and the experience that I have had using this biodegradable film. So this is the stage of the garden that it is the very most important. So all of those little weeds that you see popping up, I mean, this is just, actually they did whole weed just 2 days ago. All of those little weeds that you see popping up in the holes is what this entire bed would be covered with at this point of growth. And by having the film down and then planting your plant with only a small hole, you are holding back all of these annual weeds that you would have to be doing something with, right? So this is more basil. This is ageratum. So at this stage, I really do everything I can to preserve the integrity of the film. Meaning, when I mow, I try not to hit the edge of the mower tire is going to rip the film, right? So I'm really kind of careful. But here's the thing, y'all. Once these beds, you know, will be, once we take the row cover and bags up, then we'll be starting to net, right? And once the netting is up, these plants, I mean, in the next 2 weeks, you're not even going to be able to see film here before too long. And once that happens, I'm not quite so worried. Let's just step across here. I'm not quite so worried. These are zinnias. And this zinnia bed, you can see there's no hoops or covers. This was our experimental bed. It has been exposed to the cold all of these nights, and we're kind of comparing it to our other zinnia beds. And let's just walk down here and we'll walk over. So once the canopy of the plants grows up, then the film has kind of done its job. You know what I mean? So I'm not worried about, literally, when I am then mowing these pathways, once the canopy is mature, I literally put my tire up on the edge of the bed and mow. That's how I keep really clean edges around here. Now, this is a mixed bed of Gumpherina, and I see marigolds and cosmos and all kinds of good stuff. And you can see, there's a few weeds in here. Look at this. This has got some amaranth, which is the bane of my existence around here, right after nutsage. So at this point, this is when the Bio 360 is invaluable to us. Look at these gorgeous zinnias. And I mean, this basically needs no maintenance. We whole weeded day before yesterday because I didn't have anything else for him to do, y'all. So let's just walk up here. So these zinnias are some of the ones that were first planted. Over on this side is celosia. And I mean, people are asking me all the time, how do we grow so much with so little labor? And Bio 360 is it, y'all. I mean, I did used to stress over if the film would get ripped on the edge. Certainly, like, and you can see holes in ours. Those are deer and dog footprints. Those things happen. But my real goal, I guess you could say, is to just keep this film's integrity until the canopy covers the bed. See, look at this. All of this grassy stuff where there's holes. And we find that if we can do one hole weeding, which doesn't take long, y'all, because there's just a few holes with weeds, that again just allows the plants to really get a jump. And once the canopy has grown up, it shades the surface of the soil, which stops encouraging annual seeds to grow. I just can't even tell you how much I love this stuff. So you can find Bio 360 over on our website, thegardenersworkshop.com. We now actually sell it in 6-packs because people were buying so many multiples. You can buy it in 50-foot pieces. So here's the rest of the story of what I do, the cycle of using the Bio 360. So these plants will grow up, we'll net them, we'll harvest them for, I mean, much of the summer. At the end of their use, the bed, we take the netting off, take the stakes out. There is irrigation under the film. Water does not penetrate under this film. That's part of its weed suppressing benefit, y'all. So either put irrigation underneath or you're going to have to water from the top, and the only water that gets under is the water that goes in the holes. And that works if you get a lot of rain where you are. Anyway, we take the netting off, the stakes up, then we literally, the irrigation just pops right through. I mean, you pull it up, it just rips right through the film. It is not a burden at all. If you tear your beds down as soon as they're done, instead of allowing them to grow a bunch of weeds, y'all. And then we bush hog the bed, which will have, these flowers will be 48 inches tall. I mean, it'll be a whole mass of organic matter, right? And we'll bush hog it, then we'll till, we incorporate the film and the debris, and then wait however long it takes for it to digest, anywhere depending on the state of the crop, from a week to 2 weeks, and we make another bed and we replant. I know that I can say to you wholeheartedly that I would not be farming at the rate that I am because of the labor saving issue of this. If you're a home gardener, it is a no-brainer, y'all. I mean, you can mulch on top of this if you don't like the way it looks. But I'm telling you, once the plant canopy gets up, you don't even see it's there anymore, hardly. But you can mulch on top of it. It's made from a corn byproduct. It's made in Italy. We buy it. I have used it now for about 8 or 9 years. Totally and completely love it as a tool. However, as you saw over there, nut sage and perennial weeds will still push through it. However, it suppresses the annual weeds, which is the big pressure that I have here on my farm. So Bio360 for me is just an amazing tool, and I don't think I would be doing what I'm doing now without it. And if you want to check it out, there's videos over on the product page at thegardenersworkshop.com. It's called Bio360. Just, you can search that or just go to our store and go to supplies there. And y'all, here's the other thing that's really cool about it. So it's, we made the, this is our first warm season planting. So we used the black side up because the temperatures weren't so high here. And the black side up helps to warm the soil and the beds just a little bit. The other side of this is gray, and the gray keeps the surface cooler. So our next planting of warm season tender annuals, because it'll be in the, you know, mid 80s to high 90s in the afternoon, it doesn't take but 4 hours to toast newly planted seedlings into that kind of condition. 95 degree weather, this black surface, and they aren't established yet like they are now, it would toast them. They're now prepared to face that. But our next planting will be in the heat of summer. So we will then, when we make our beds, put them gray side up, and that does all the weed suppressing values that we've benefited from here, but it also keeps the surface of the bed cooler. And I will tell you that, yes, I do have a tractor that makes these beds and lays the film, but I made Bio 360 beds by hand for like 3 years before I got a tractor with a bed layer. We also have a video on the product page showing you how to do that. And hey, if you have any questions or issues, connect with me here. I do lives on Wednesdays on Instagram, Saturdays on Facebook. Bring your questions, comments, and I'll be happy to talk to you about it. But I will tell you that Bio 360 is a big part of how I was able to ramp up my garden, to build my business with less labor, a more efficient, and it's a better garden, y'all. I mean, it's just, it's really going to get beautiful. And be sure to check out the Farm Cam stream to watch this garden grow. So I'm hoping on Monday, all of these bags and row covers will be cleared away. I start mowing. The weekly mowing of the pathways, y'all, I do it. It's like my cardio workout for the week. I use a push mower. It's the meanest little push mulching mower on the planet. Anyway, we'll talk more about that once I start using it. I'll just pan over to my cool flower garden over here, which is what we're getting ready to start harvesting. So friends, I hope this has helped you understand how Bio 360 works, how it can help you in your garden, and It's just getting the learning curve of how to use it and apply it to your garden. So friends, till we meet again, I'm off to back to doing chores. Ciao.